Good morning. My name is Pam Harris, and I'm your Vice President. On behalf of the NACOM Board of Directors, we sincerely hope that you're enjoying your stay here at the conference, as well as this beautiful resort facility. We would like to take this opportunity to thank all of you for attending this conference, knowing that for many of you, the costs were borne out of your own pockets. And we truly hope that you have found the educational and social events beneficial to you. Just a few announcements. Please be considerate of your colleagues and turn your cell phones off or to on vibrate during the sessions. We would like to thank BJA and American University for their continued support in providing workshop support to us at our mid-year and annual meetings. Please be reminded that American University and BJA provide technical assistance to courts across the nation in the criminal area. It's free. You can contact them, and they will help you with any issue that you are having. So thank you very much, BJA and American University. If you registered by the early bird cutoff date of June 17th, you are eligible to win a weekend here at the Red Rock Resort. The drawing will be at Thursday's closing, which I'll talk a little bit more about, so please show up at the closing, and I think you might be very surprised to have another weekend here at this beautiful resort. The AIA sessions today at 1:30, there were two. They have been combined. They are getting better court facilities and changing times, challenging times, and how am I ever going to get my courthouse built in this economy? They are combining the two. We think it'll be a very rich session for you to attend, and it will be in Veranda C. The silent auction that we had out in front here all day raised $1,000 for the Las Vegas YMCA. We have three winners still that need to pick up their items at the registration desk. That's Dwayne Delaney, Tammy Grimm, and Pam DeVault. Please don't forget your winnings. Your boarding passes for your flights can be printed at the computer in the hallway. Please feel free to do so. We'd like to thank our sponsors once again, our diamond sponsor Adobe and Sustain, our platinum sponsors Thomson's Reuters, our gold Fact and HOK, silver ACS and Dun & Bradstreet, and all the other participating sponsors are on the back of your notebook, and we thank them. We can't do what we do without them. And here's one thing that we had a happy birthday yesterday to Dwayne Delaney from Washington, D.C. Happy birthday, Dwayne. Also, there's evaluations in the middle of your tables. Please fill them out. They help us with future events. So we really need you to fill them out. And you can leave them on the table, or someone will be at the back door to pick them up if you want to give them to a live person. At 11:45, following the morning workshops, we'll have the NACOM business meeting here in the Summerlin Ballroom. We ask that all of you please try to attend. Following the afternoon workshops at 3:15, we welcome you to the NACOM closing session where the President will report on future conferences and our national agenda. And that concludes the housekeeping items. Therefore, as we all know, we need to perform more. We still have so much to learn. We have so much to learn about the business of delivering justice. I really know that because they're here trying. Administration. Looking forward. assist them of being a lawyer. She also worked with a former governor, division chief counsel, and family protection, specializing in child abuse and neglect cases. She's done a lot. As Marcus Rankinsmeyer
for some of the material at the end of this presentation, because the material is woven in and out fairly deeply, and so that seems to be the best way to do this. So, mission is we for now. And you know, for the first time, don't rely on what we've called mission in the past, because we have new circumstances. And we need confidence. We could all list various attributes, and here's some that I thought of. Right, and remember that we are the third branch of government in this difficult budget crisis, and because of that, we have some clout. Our doors is not an option. Recommend divert your course to the south to avoid a collision. United States Navy, divert your course now. Station 2, Sound Lighthouse, and it's your call. We the courts in our budget, but what we focus on more strategic ways of taking care of our budget needs, we will end up paralysis. So what is paralysis? You have the public not wanting any new spending. You have the Republicans not wanting. You have the market not wanting any new bargain. All the above leads to paralysis. So how do we get out of paralysis? One way is by realizing what the odds are against us. Reality amongst those who are in touch with it. But as a lifestyle, I find and expects me to be there for it all the time. And with all that I have to do, I had to let something go. Oh, there we go. Room. Indicating the budget gaps in fiscal years 08 through 2013. states restricted low-income children for access to health services. Meal programs for seniors. Going the wrong way. Difficulty in raising through the steps of the organization. Down and battle the budget and upper man. On both sides of that, specialized court services. increasing training and state travel. It's amazing to me that so many of you were able to be here. With the way the conveyor belt is timed, and they do well. And what happens at the end? Well, they just can't keep up, and a solution would be to call in Ricky. What we need is a belt. And so that's a way three levels. We will have emergencies, imminent threats of bodily harm, like domestic violence. How they are to handle this. So here's a slide that I'm particularly wrong time is the necessarily. Well, that's about tactics. Here. Besides chopping down the barrier, there are more sophisticated ways that we can handle the barrier. Well, strategies are streamline court case and paper. We need to cut back on ill-used our court services and look for grants. policies. And finally, interpreters, those skills and importance. There was a movie with Patrick Swayze. This movie was a little more, and he helps a little more, and then he realizes that he got himself trapped . Let's talk about a few attributes. When I was typing this up,